Hello, my beautiful, wonderful viewers. Welcome back to my channel. This is a very sad one. It's about the killings in Benue State. The herdsmen, the Fulani people that attacked refugee camp, what they call IDP camp, but it's refugee camp in Benue State. The governor cried and cried. I have to show you the video. But before then, please, if you are new to my channel, please support the channel by subscribing, share the video, hit the red button so that each time I upload video, you will be notified, be the first to know. So let's go straight to the video and then we may continue the discussion.
It is an unfortunate development that what is happening, if the federal government have taken proactive steps, today we will not be where we are. These cops you are seeing here, in the last 2 weeks, we are burying over 70 people just in Makurdi local government alone. This is not acceptable. Go to Guma, the same killings are taking place. Go to Gwawas. The same killings are taking place. This is not right. The federal government have refused to take proactive steps to arrest this ugly situation that we're witnessing here today. You will recall that I alerted the entire nation when Fulanese in 14 countries met in Yola and declared that except we repeal the prohibition of open grazing law, Benue will not know peace. And on the ground, I did say that I was targeted for elimination, to be assassinated, and that was done on me. It's only God that saved me. And I did say they are going after my people. So federal government should arrest the leadership of Mayor Tiala Cotton Horry that hosted that meeting. Up to today, nothing has been done. This is really unfortunate. It means we don't have a government in place at the federal level. We don't have a government. This is very sad. Because if proactive steps were taken by arresting Mayor Tiala leadership, this will not happen. For several years, we have been calling on federal government to take proactive steps to address this matter. They have refused to do. You can imagine. This is a bag in an IDP camp. The adjoining villages here, with the real camp and the adjoining villages, are occupied by IDPs. And what else do you want them to do? You send these people away from their villages. They came here to take refuge. And today, they are being killed in this manner. Over 70 people have been killed in the last 2 weeks by this herdsmen. They no longer come with their cattle. They come because they are looking for livestock they are to kill. They have even sent messages that except livestock guard refuse to take their cattle so that they will come and graze on our farms. And this we say no, it will not be accepted. What kind of a thing is it? What kind of a country we are in? Mr. President said the other day that the security men should shoot anyone with AK-47. And up to today, we have not heard where security men have shot them. The Minister of Defense came and reversed what Mr. President said, that they said they are arrested and prosecuted. Where are we going? How do you wake up every day and you see your people being killed? How can I be a happy man with this kind of a thing? How can I be a happy man? So please, Mr. President must do the needful. And I want to suggest that immediately let there be a security summit. I'm aware that in Niger, in Zamfara, all over the country, northeast, northwest, north central, southeast, south south, south west, all the places, this kind of barbaric act is being taken by the same Fulanis. And people are afraid to say, and they give them a name, bandit. They are not bandit, they are Fulanis. These ones that came here, look at the best ways that they were seeing, and they were speaking that language. And they came and insisted that they must take government to proscribe or repeal the prohibition of open grazing act. That will not happen. It is not my making. It's the people of Benue State that told me to do that law. I didn't sit on my own and did any law. And so no one should try and make anything. You know? So this is sad. This is sad. This is sad. My heart bleeds. And President Buhari must arise to his responsibility as the commander-in-chief of the armed forces. If he doesn't do it, our people say that the goat doesn't bite. But when you push it to the wall, it will bite. This is not right. This is not accepted. This is not accepted. President Buhari was elected by the people. He must arise and do something. No other person has the responsibility of arming the security men and providing enough equipment and funding to ensure that they eradicate this. This is too sad. Buhari cannot be playing us around because these are Fulani men doing the same thing. As I said, they want to take over our land. If not, what is the excess? You send people away from their farms and here they are in IDP camp, you come and kill them. What else do you want me to say? Buhari, if you were the governor of Benue State, what do you want me to say? You must arise and do something to stop it. They are your kinsmen. Call them and tell them this is enough is enough. This is being taking us for granted too far. And this will not be accepted. I know the implication of telling people to go on self-help. And I want to repeat my call that if you are serious on this security matter, Mr. President, allow us to buy AK-47. This is what I said. He was licensed so that we too can face them. You have armed your brothers. You have armed your brothers. And you have disarmed us. I saw somewhere where security men arrested those people who had cutlasses, who had swords, who had this thing because they are from Benue State. How about the Fulani men? You know where they are. Go and disarm them. You give an order. Your defense minister will reverse the order. What kind of a thing is that? This is very, very sad. President Buhari, we are not asking you to protect us because we want favor from you. It is your responsibility. You must arise. All this while getting your heads to speak on security matter, it is wrong. You must stand up and address the nation and declare emergency on security. Call a security summit, bring all of us together, and let us agree. And you must be sincere this time, not just playing on us. This is too far. Enough is enough. If you want to kill us, come and kill us. They will know that you were elected to kill all of us. And you kill them. You're ready. I'm ready for them. I'm 60 years. I'm ready to go. If you must come and kill us, come and kill us. Come and kill me. Because I cannot be presiding over dead people. This is enough.
Look forward. Look here. Okay, Mr. President, we want justice. Justice must prevail. We want you to allow us to use AK-47 the same way the Fulanis are using.
Yes.
Yesterday we saw them with our eyes. They were speaking Fulanis, not armed bandits. It was Fulanis we saw them. They came and attacked this village. They killed more than 20 people. Their aim was to attack the IDP camp. But because of the neighboring villages, they killed and some with injured others. Some are at the hospital right now. Mr. President, if you know you are in power, if you know you are the president of this country, we voted for you. And you must rise and do something. Yes, we'll do our best. We must do our best. My name is Mr. Amos Amu. I'm the leader, youth leader of this community. This is Abagina village. Thank you.
I'm from this community. At about 12 o'clock last night, or this morning, I was working with the news that the Fulani herdsmen have killed so many people in this community. And this is not the only community I'm presiding over. They were recently, just about 5 days ago, they killed so many within the same community. And they have been killing, there have been so many killings, and we, as a community will say this should be the last killing. Otherwise, we go to self-help. Self-help. If government cannot, the federal government has refused to provide security for the community, provide security for the people of Benue State and Nigeria at large. So we will resort to self-help.
How many people are here today?
We can see 6 corpses. Others are in the hospital. We do not know how many.
I'm the prominent son of Benue State. This is my place. Abagana. Hallelujah. This is Abagana. And yesterday night, they called us that the Fulani people have invaded. My sister is here while I was in Agan. This didn't happen exactly some few minutes to 12. Before the information reached the community, it was already 12 o'clock. So it is sad. And what I want to tell the president is that he should arise as how the governor is telling him. That he should arise with responsibilities. This is sardonic. We are not happy any longer. Like, for instance, I would like to blame our governor in some instance that he has collected our weapons. He has collected our weapons since the history of the Tiv nations. No tribe and nobody has ever defeated the Tiv people. But because the governor has collected our weapons, now we are helpless. They say that we should submit our arms. We have submit our arms. And now the Fulanis, they are attacking us. We don't have any other thing to do. There's no call. They say anybody that move with cutlasses that they should arrest him. The Fulanis that move with AK-47, and nobody is here to say anything. There was no security in IDP. They came exactly to attack the IDP. It was because of the neighboring people that we are close to this place.
It's happening. Within the last 2 weeks, we have lost more than 70 people between the local governments of Makurdi, Guma, and Gwe West. Just alone. In addition to what you're seeing here today, many are in hospital, apart from the 6 that were killed, and 1 died in hospital. So that the 7 people died, and others are still in the hospital. My deputy is going there now. But I want to say that we are being overstretched. Our patience and our preaching of rule of law and due process. You can see that the people are fed up. Mr. President must rise up. He's the president of Federal Republic of Nigeria, and over the 250 nationalities that are in this country, Mr. President is their president. They voted him. We all voted him. He's our president. He has taken oath of office to secure the country and provide security for lives and property. This is unacceptable. This cannot continue. Mr. President cannot continue to be aloof. Mr. President must rise up to address the nation himself, not Garba Shehu or any of his assistants. Mr. President must tell us where we are going in this country. This is too much. We are being overstretched, and this is not acceptable. The body language, the action and inaction of Mr. President shows that he's only the president of Fulani people. I have warned this. I have written to him, I have written to the security agencies that Mayor Tiala anchored a meeting in Yola and said that except we repeal the prohibition of open grazing law, otherwise nobody will know this. They will kill, they will maim, they will rape, they will do all kind of atrocity. They have started doing it. And it's amazing. We're becoming a banana republic. If we have a president, Mr. President gives order, gave security agencies orders to shoot at sight whosoever is having AK-47. And then the Minister of Defense came out to say that they cannot shoot at sight. Those people should be prosecuted. So who is Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces? So this kind of game, these lies, this falsehood that is being played out, it is not acceptable. It is better for me not to be alive to see this kind of shame of leadership. What is going on? Nigerians, my colleagues, governors, we must arise and impress on the president to call a security summit. If possible, ensure that the state of emergency is declared on security so that all hands will be on deck to address this matter. But what is happening now, to me, it is very clear. Mr. President is just working for these Fulanis to take over the whole country. His body language is what is being played out. Mr. President gives order, and another person, minister, come and counter it. Is that not a shame? Just like the first lady said sometimes ago, where are the men in this country?
to come out and confront this, that is Mr. President's wife coming out to lament and to cry and to say that Nigerians should arise, that something is wrong. The president must tell us what is wrong with him so that we can all help him. I want to call on my colleagues, the governors, because after presidency is the governors. We must work hard to ensure that we salvage this country. Otherwise, this country where I'm seeing it is being drowned. And we must salvage it. Otherwise, tomorrow we wake up, there will be no country. You can imagine if I have not been there, that major road is blocked. You can imagine what will start happening. So this is it. We can't allow you to take over the place. But that is what they're agitating now. I said, goat does not bite. But when goat is pushed to the wall, it bites. That is where we are. We are fed up. We don't want to restore to something. We believe in the unity of this country. And that is what I've been preaching. But we're being overstretched.